Good morning, friends. Now we will see what is the difference between area and volume of any figure. Do you know? Area is the space being occupied by an object when laid on the floor. But volume is actually the capacity, the space inside that container. How much quantity of a thing it can contain. Volume of a 3D figure is found out, but area is of 2D figure. So you should understand, if I just say this is a hemisphere, okay, what is the area? Area means when it is totally laid on the floor, how much space it is occupying. But volume is how much thing it can contain inside. So now onward, volume and area should be very much clear to you. Now we will see what the formulas for different areas and volumes are there. The first 3D figure is cuboid. You know volume? Very simple, LBH. And area? Do you know how many sides are there in a cuboid? To this side, to that side, to upper and bottom. So total 6 sides are there. So area of a cuboid is, volume we have written, 2LB plus BH plus LH. Very simple. You just remember the things, area and volume, and this is a very common thing. Everybody is knowing this. If we have to talk about the cube, what's the volume? Cube volume, you can easily say volume of a cube is L cube, or you can say A cube, side cube. And the area, you know, 6 sides are there and every side is a square. So sum of areas of all 6 sides, all 6 squares is 6A square. This is cube. If we now just go for cylinder, what's the volume? This is pi r square h, very common. Pi r square h. People say, how it is coming pi r square h? You see, if you just see the figure of a cylinder, see that it is a stack of circles. One circle, another circle, another circle, so many circles up to height h are there. So if we multiply the area of cross section means the smallest part of that figure, with the height, it gives some volume. So one very important formula we have seen, that volume is actually the area of cross section into height. So volume is pi r square, that is the area of the cross section, and height. Area of cylinder is pi 2 pi r h. This is curved surface area. You know what is curved surface area? Curved surface area, the area which is curved, which we can just stress like this. So we can test the cylinder's outside portion. You can say lateral portion, and that is 2 pi r h. If we need to find total surface area, what is that? 2 pi r h plus 2 extra circles are there, one at top, one at bottom. This is 2 pi r square. Now go for cone. Volume of cone, that is 1 by 3 pi r square. You can easily realize this, that each cone is 1/3 of the cylinder of which it is a part. So volume of the cone is 1/3 pi r square h. Curved surface area, here it is pi r l. You know what is that? L is long height actually. You see, if I'm drawing here, L is this. This is r, this is h. So relation between r, h and l you can easily obtain with Pythagoras theorem. L square is equal to r square plus h square. Why I am just obtaining this relation? Sometimes L is not given, R and H is given. We can easily find it. y upon Pythagoras theorem. So curved surface area is pi r. If it is the curved surface area plus one circle is there, so total surface area of a cone is pi r n plus pi r square. Very easy. You are understanding the things. Now go for the sphere. You remember what's the volume of sphere? This is 4 by 3 pi r cube. And the area is 4 pi r square. If I ask what is the curved surface area and what's the total surface area of a sphere, can you tell me? See, the curved surface area of a sphere is actually the total surface area because it's got only the curved part. So, the curved surface area, a total surface area, what they are talking about? It is 4 pi r square. Now see, hemisphere. This is hemisphere. You know, volume is half of that of sphere. So if it is 4 by 3, this will be 2 by 3 pi r cube. And area. Here, the curved surface area and total surface area is coming into play. The curved surface area is 2 pi r square. Not a problem. But if I say total surface area of a hemisphere, it will be, you can tell me, 2 pi r square plus 1 circle, that is pi r square. So you can easily find the area and volume of the hemisphere. One more thing I have to discuss regarding the area and volume. Hollow thing. If a thing is hollow and they ask the volume of the metal in that hollow figure. Suppose a cylinder is hollow and we need to find the volume of the metal. What planning we can do if we just find the outer volume and subtract the inner volume, we will get the volume of the metal. Very simple. Anyway, if you just find hollow thing, that is concentric things, you can find the volume of the metal or volume of the thing of which it is made up of very easily. So cylinder volume will be pi capital R square minus pi small r square into h. This is the volume of hollow cylinder. If I say volume of, if you need to find volume of hollow sphere, what will be that? You can easily say 4 by 3 pi capital R cube minus 4 by 3 pi small r cube. So very easy, wherever we have to talk about the volume of the metal in a hollow figure, you just write outer volume minus inner volume. That is the universal formula. Sometimes what is happening, we are melting one thing and making the small things with that melted portion. How many that small things are being made? The simple concept is, I just recommend you write the first line correctly. Your question is solved. And the first line is volume of the thing which we are melting. We can say volume of first thing is equal to volume of the second thing. Total volume of the second thing. Suppose we are melting a sphere whose radius is 5. So volume of that will be 4 by 3 pi 5 cube. Okay? Solid sphere. And we are making small spheres of radius 1. How many such small spheres are possible? Suppose n small spheres are possible. So volume of the first thing which is being melted is equal to volume of total volume of the things which we are making. We are making n small spheres and the volume of each small sphere is 4 by 3 pi 1 cube, like that. If the radius is 1, we can easily find the number of things we made. You just cancel it out here. This is 125. So 125 small sphere can be made. So very simple. Wherever you are melting something, write the line, the volume of the thing which is being melt, and the complete total volume of the thing which is being made. One more example I am taking. If I am just melting a sphere of radius 10 centimeter and making cylinders of radius 1 and height 2. Okay, how many such cylinders will be possible? Volume of the ring which is being melted and into the volume of the small things we are making. Pi r square, suppose radius is 1 and height is 2. Pi r square. With the sphere, this you might have seen that we are melting the gold, we are going to the jeweler and making the small ornaments. The same thing, whatever we are giving to the jeweler, that much gold is there. And the total volume of the thing which is made with that volume should be equal to the thing we have given. Same concept we are applying here. Volume of the thing is equal to n times the volume of the small things. So n we can easily find. So n, by applying this thing, we can find out very easily how many things are possible. That concept you have to remember all the time. What happens sometimes? A figure is not a single figure. It is made up of two combined figures. Suppose a cone is there and on the cone a hemisphere is there. This is being melted or whatever is being done. The volume of this thing is, what is that? You know, the volume of the cone 1 by 3 pi r squared plus volume of hemisphere, that is 2 by 3 pi r. So, wherever combined figure is there, you need to find the volume of the thing separately and then proceed. What happens sometimes, this toy, suppose this is a toy in this shape, is being put in a bucket, cylindrical format, and it is filled with water to some height. What is the rise in level of water by dropping this inside the bucket? You know, cylindrical bucket, you know, the volume of rise in water, the volume of the level rise, suppose from here it is coming here, this much volume is equal to the volume of the toy being inserted in it. So, volume of rise in level in water, you see the figure, this is cylindrical, pi r square h. That is the volume of rise in level in of water. H is what? You know, H is the rise, not the total height. T is equal to the volume of the thing inserted in. So, if I am taking this thing as capital R, this as capital S, will be equal to the complete thing. If we have inserted this toy, plus 2 by 3 pi r. So, put the given data, suppose it is given, R is given, this R is given, this H is given, we can find the rise in level of water. Very simple. Whatever thing is happening is equal to the volume of the thing which we are using to thing to happen. We are putting it inside it. Level of water is rising, which is responsible, this toy is responsible. So, rise in level of water is equal to volume of the thing which we inserted. You just follow these basic things, maturational part, 3D part is going to be very, very easy. Hope you are enjoying. Okay, thank you, bye-bye.
If you like my videos, please do subscribe my channel and share my videos. Thank you.